So, to say the least, I am overly ecstatic for Persona 5 Strikers. Or Scramble. Whatever you want to call it. I prefer to call it Scramble, but us Americans get the other end of the bargain, so it doesn't really matter. But Persona 5 Scramble is the Warriors game to Persona 5. And supposedly, it works as a sequel. Also, it makes the original Persona 5 canon and almost disregards Royal, and I'm gonna be genuinely honest, I'm okay with that. But there is also a catch on how I'm playing it. I'm playing it on the Switch, and if Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity told me anything, it doesn't directly mean it's gonna be a sequel. But I like the Warriors game. Yeah, the big slashy slash.
Considering how much I loved Age of Calamity, making me love this style of game, the fact that my favorite game of all time is making its rekindling in this type of style makes me like a little kid right before his birthday. Now yes, I did overrate the basic storytelling of Age of Calamity because my tremendous bias towards Breath of the Wild, but I had so much fun with the game, and its simple storytelling did open cool interactions within the gameplay that it just made me happy to play it. Now here's the thing. Persona 5 Scramble, though yes, I've played the demo in Japanese, not understood any piece of what anybody was saying or doing, and all around was just really confused, I still enjoyed the demo, and it made me excited for what's to come.
Yet there are some things that I would want in this game to make it just that much better, and yeah, hopefully a 9.5 again. But with how much I love Persona 5, obviously I'm gonna try and get picky with this. Anyway, let's get into it.
First of all, I'm currently playing through Persona 3, and I'm loving it. I do have to admit, with Persona, it does feel great with its style. It always absorbs and embraces it, all in the UI, the music, the story, always. And this new style in Scramble seems to be somewhat bubbly and developed around an app, which is reminiscent of Persona 5's MetaNav. So, that's my first note. Embrace the style and atmosphere. If this game adapts the UI to have a bubbly yet serious spirit to it, then Persona is easily captured. These characters I bet are still the same, with the writer still on board and Yusuke still looking for Hot Lobster. I believe so far it's capturing a good spirit, but has some potential to really capture a Scramble of greatness when mixed with the style.
You see what I did there?
Well, as I mentioned earlier, the characters. And there's two new characters. One in specific seems to be a full-on new character to the Phantom Thieves, Zenkichi. I'll call him Z so I don't mispronounce his name again, so Biggie Z here is netted directly into the story and seemingly is a new boy for whatever palace is gonna come. I think they're called jails? Now, I love each character's story from Royal and the original Persona 5, developing once per palace, giving each the spotlight. Well, mostly, I mean, Haru didn't get screen time. But what they did do to make Makoto and Kasumi the best girls in Persona 5 are, is developed them before their palace. And that makes my second note, make me care about Z before he gets a persona. He won't feel like a big just plot device if they do this. And if D-Machina told me anything, I don't like mass plot convenience. Yeah, there's a few loopholes in Persona, but those can mostly be explained throughout the story. And yet small details hint to the explanation. D-Machina just booms the dark ether in your face, and Persona should not do that with Big Z. That, my friends, would break a piece of Persona off. Its storytelling isn't as simple as something like Zelda, and it shouldn't report to basic devices if it wants to capture its anime audience. Now, on the topic of basic plot, the Velvet Room is a given, and there were slight hints to something happening in Scramble. So, on my third note, and a shorter one, embrace the Velvet Room in story. I know it's already technically out, but I genuinely hope the Velvet Room is directly involved in the story. Like, please make me care about Lavenza and Igor more than I already do if something's happened to them. The introduction to Persona 5 is a little bit rough, but their characters pick up as the plot continues. Please incorporate small hints and reminders that Lavenza and Igor need your help. Please, make me a real trick star. Hey, stop! I'm a weeb! But, not that much. Yet. Something I loved about Persona was how the villains were introduced. They were linked to the characters, but also linked to the overall plot, showing both cutscenes and battles alike. People like Kamoshida, genuine pieces of complete making me motivated to continue. Now they were both changed in real life and the Shadow Metaverse forms, and voila, it made me care about how they changed in both sides of the story. And the one thing I will say, Scramble better do that. So, the fourth note. Develop the villains outside of the metaverse. I've seen a lot of bosses or maybe mini-bosses in trailers and in games, so if they're all evil beings of mass destruction, make me see their motivation to do evil before we tackle them. Pop idol or not, this Harley Quinn archetype seems to introduce cool gameplay, but I hope she also introduces a meaningful story. I mean, yeah, there's gonna be an overall plot, but I need a reason to make the entire bombardment of Jack Frost's. Please. I already love this scene. Please. Now, the last note is a bit more tough, but either a make or a break. The game's already done some patching up and pretty much all you can do, but because of the little bit I've played, I'm hoping, for my last note, to have a streamlined ability and upgrade system. The little intricacies of Persona 5 systems allowed both a simple leveling system and enough adaptation to make any piece of the game feel nice and adaptable to your playstyle. It would change around, developing on the point that you are in the game, but to be honest, the Persona ability and magic used in Scramble feel a little bit strange, and if they take the parkour aspect to heart, it could easily become really cool. I'd want to see an adaptable but streamlined leveling system, making a continuous challenge throughout the game. Age of Calamity did make me feel overpowered unless I was equally leveled, but it gave me a bit more XP than I needed at times. I'd believe it made up for that in the post-game though, but in the mainline story, it didn't feel like much, if any, of a challenge. Scramble, in my hopes, would have a way to level up and adapt, but give off enough challenge that it doesn't become repetitive over and over dubs. I mean, the way Age of Calamity sort of adapted around this was variety in enemies, and I hope Scramble does this by use of new abilities instead throughout the game, tackling everything with a new strategy. I already understand the array of enemies because it's Persona, you've got a lot to work with, but I do hope there's a lot more abilities I can just use. I hope. Please.
Well, that was my wish list. We've got until February 22nd to discover if any of these actually happened within the game. And if I'm honest, I can't wait to see the development of Sophie the Robot and Big Z, as well as just return to the characters I absolutely adore. At least that's my hopes. And to finish it off, I will take your heart again on February 22nd. I'll see y'all next time.